This is the Prelab video for Chem 1020 Experiment 6, Thin Layer Chromatography, or TLC. TLC is a quick and easy way to analyze mixtures. Professional chemists use TLC all the time. For instance, it's a simple way to tell whether or not a chemical reaction is complete. In this experiment, you'll be given an unknown mixture of over-the-counter drugs, and you'll use TLC to figure out how many substances are in that unknown, and you'll identify those substances by comparing them with known samples. You can follow along with the procedure printed in your lab manual.
Safety glasses or goggles must be worn for the entire experiment. The solvents we will use may dry or irritate your skin, so be careful when you're pouring them. You may want to wear gloves if you have sensitive skin. We also need to make sure that no solvent vapors get into our breathing air, so the solvents will only be used under the fume hoods. Make sure the hood sash is pushed back down whenever possible. First, you'll prepare a developing chamber under the hood by pouring a pre-made developing solvent mixture into a 1-liter beaker to a depth of about a half a centimeter. Cover the beaker with plastic wrap or a large watch glass. When the container is airtight like this, the solvent vapors will fill the chamber and the developing process later will work much better. Set the chamber aside under the hood for later. Get a TLC sheet from your instructor. The TLC sheets we use are made of flexible plastic coated on one side with a brittle powder. Handle the sheet very carefully. It usually works best to lay it on a paper towel with the powdery side up. Don't touch the powdery side because fingerprints can show up later. Also, check to make sure there aren't any chips missing from the lower corners or edges. Your instructor may help you carefully trim your sheet if it's damaged. Use a pencil to draw a light line on the powdery side about 1 centimeter from the bottom. Then draw 6 hash marks evenly spaced along the line, leaving a little extra room on the edges. If your TLC sheets are smaller, your instructor may have you use 2 sheets. These hash marks are where the samples will get applied. Now, obtain a known drug sample. It's just an over-the-counter drug ground into a powder. There are 4 knowns in this experiment. Choose one of the knowns to prepare, and other groups will prepare the others. Scoop a small amount on the tip of your flat spatula and place it in a clean, dry 50 milliliter beaker. Then, under the hood, add 2 milliliters of hexanes and 2 milliliters of ethanol. Use your stirring rod to mix. The active ingredients will dissolve in the solvent, but some of the starch and other inactive ingredients may not completely dissolve. Return the container with the powdered known substance for others to use. Label the beaker with the name of the known substance and place 1 capillary tube in the beaker. It's important that this capillary tube only be used for this sample. Capillary tubes never come clean, so if we used this tube for other samples, the tube would still be contaminated with previous samples and they would show up in our TLC analysis. Leave the labeled beaker with the capillary tube under the hood. Now, get an unknown sample from your instructor. Be sure to write down the unknown's number. Prepare it in the same way you prepared the known sample. Place a small amount in a separate 50 milliliter beaker and add ethanol and hexane under the hood. Stir, label the beaker, and add a capillary tube. Return the remainder of the powdered unknown to your instructor. At this point, you should have your developing chamber, a dissolved known sample, and a dissolved unknown sample. Capillary tubes are hollow glass tubes that are so skinny that a liquid will flow up into it on its own. We use them to apply small amounts of a sample onto a TLC sheet. Grab a small scrap TLC sheet to practice using the capillary. Hold the capillary straight up and down, dip it in a dissolved sample, and very briefly touch it to the TLC sheet. This should leave a spot that's around 1 millimeter across. We want the spot to be as small and concentrated as possible. Holding it longer makes a larger spot. Now, apply the known and unknown drug samples to your TLC sheet in this order. Your unknown will be in the outermost positions, 1 and 6, And the known samples that you and your classmates prepared will be in the inner positions, 2 through 5. This way, your unknown is spotted on both sides of the knowns you're comparing it to. Spot your unknown in positions 1 and 6, and spot the known that you prepared in its correct position. Then, take your TLC sheet around the room, using the known samples that other groups prepared, until you have all the samples spotted on your TLC sheet in their correct positions. The powder on the TLC sheets we use contains a dye that glows under ultraviolet light. These drug samples absorb UV light, so when you view your spotted plate under UV light, the samples should show up as small dark spots. If any of the spots are lighter than the others, you can spot that position again to apply some more sample, then check under the UV light once again. Once all your spots look good, you're ready to carefully lower your TLC sheet into the developing chamber and replace the cover. Make sure the sides of the sheet don't touch the beaker, and make sure the spots remain above the surface of the liquid. That's why we poured the developing solvent to a depth of 0.5 centimeter, while the spots were made 1 centimeter from the bottom of the TLC sheet. The solvent will slowly wick up through the sheet, carrying the applied samples along with it, but different substances climb the sheet at different rates. Some substances are more attracted to the stationary phase, the powder on the sheet, so they'll travel slowly. Some are more attracted to the mobile phase, the solvent, so they'll travel more quickly. Remove the TLC sheet once the solvent has made it up to about 1 or 2 centimeters from the top. Place it on a paper towel and use a pencil to mark the solvent front. We'll need to know later how far the solvent traveled, so be sure to mark it before the solvent evaporates. Leave your sheet under the hood for a few minutes until the solvent has evaporated and your sheet is dry. Take your developed sheet and again view it under UV light. You should now be able to see how the spots migrated up the plate from their original positions. Circle them with a pencil and return to the lab. Once all the groups are finished with the known chemicals, you can dispose of all your chemicals into a waste container. Capillary tubes need to go into the designated broken glass container. Compare your unknown spots to the known spots. You should be able to match its components to the knowns based on how far they traveled. For instance, in this TLC plate, the unknown has 2 components which match the known samples in positions 4 and 5. To record this data, you'll need to measure the distance from the starting line to the center of each spot. If your unknown has multiple spots, you need to measure to the center of each spot. The distance the spots travel will depend on the size of your TLC sheet, but a substance that moves halfway up a sheet should move halfway up any size sheet. That's why we need to calculate the retention factor, or RF, of each spot. The RF is calculated by dividing the distance the spot traveled by the distance the solvent traveled. So, the spot that went halfway up the sheet will have an RF around 0.5. Notice RF has no units because the units cancel when you divide 2 lengths. The RF will be a value between 0 and 1 and is consistent for a certain compound and a set of experimental conditions. You can use the RF values to verify the identity of the compounds in your unknown sample. The RF values in your unknown should be similar to the RF values of the known compounds you matched them with. On the data page, make a neat table with rows and columns that organizes your data. Include the starting position, the distance to the spots, the RF, and the identity of each spot in your unknown and known samples. You're also asked about what your sheet would look like if you mistakenly used the same capillary tube for all of your samples, and you're asked to draw what a developed TLC sheet would look like with data from a different TLC experiment. When you're finished, your instructor will take a look at your data page and TLC sheet and let you know how you did at identifying your unknown. Remember the safety precautions for this experiment. Eye protection is required. Solvents must be kept under the fume hoods at all times. Avoid skin contact with the solvents used in this experiment, and wear gloves if you have sensitive skin. Dispose of all chemical waste in the waste container, and dispose of capillary tubes in the broken glass container.
After completing this experiment, you should have a basic familiarity with the principles of chromatography, and TLC in particular. TLC is especially useful in quickly and easily identifying the components of a mixture. You can feel free to try some chromatography on your own at home, analyzing the pigments in candies, markers, leaves, or flowers. Cut up some filter paper to use as a stationary phase and experiment with different solvents, like rubbing alcohol or fingernail polish remover. A simple web search on paper chromatography can get you started. Have fun and be safe.